So, battery build today, sand battery. The plan's quite simple. I've got loads of sand and it's wet. So I figure I might as well use this to try and dry it out. So in here, I've got some old bricks. And they're a little bit damp as well, so they need drying out. So my plan is to just run this heater with a layer of bricks and sand. I'm using the bricks to just take up some of the volume, make it easier to disassemble if I want to just pull the bricks out. But yeah, I'll do a layer, try and dry that out as best I can, and then come up another layer. And I'm hoping that what also it does is gives it a bit more structure so that it holds the angle of the pipes. Because obviously we don't want any condensation forming in a low spot. I want it to constantly run out. So we're going to run that. Also, I want to keep an eye on this because when I did these flanges in the last video, there was some soot on the exhaust, which we haven't had before. So that's a bit of a concern. Is this thing running too rich? Condensation wise, it's dripping out constantly. So it's obviously coming out. So that's fine. I don't think that's going to be a problem now, providing we can keep this pipe, you know, falling down. I'm concerned about soot, but we're going to run it. This will take a few hours. Obviously, I'm not going to sit you through that. It'll be the longest video ever watching sand dry. But I'll bring you back as we put more stages in. But let's have a look in here, see where we are so far and what this lot's all about. That came out of a 25 kilo bag. That came out of a 25 kilo bag. But which one looks bigger? And can you see all the water? I put them down on this 6mm ply, same time. Emptied that one. There's hardly any sort of bleeding of the water. If you look at this, I suspect I've paid for a lot of water in that bag. But yeah, there's a thing. Doesn't look quite right to me, but there you go. Are we buying water rather than sand? Right, so there's the story so far. Hope you can see down there. There's a brick. There's another one there. So I'm just going to build this up in layers because I don't want this pipe, when it gets warm, to drop and form like a dip. So I figured if I put some bricks, they might just help the stability of the sand. But I'm going to run this now, try and get some heat in here. Also what I've done, I've just added a vent, which is just a 22mm elbow with a straight connector soldered through, and then I just chopped it off because it didn't need it to be that long. But that's just so this can't pressurize, because obviously them bricks are damp, the sand's definitely wet. I'm going to try and get as much of the moisture out as I can, but obviously there's going to be some left in there. So rather than this try and blow up to a balloon, I mean, it'll pop this out before anything serious happens, but I'll put the vent in, and then that just should let any pressure out and any moisture out, hopefully. So I'm going to run this, and then I'll bring you back once it's warmed up. That doesn't look right. We've not had that before. I was bringing you out to show you the condensation on it, but that doesn't look right at all. I don't even know if that's going to actually fire up. That's unburnt fuel. I think we might have a carbon problem. Well, this just took a dramatic turn of events. Jesus, that stinks. Right, okay. I don't even know if that's going to fire out or if it's worth even bothering. I think we need to take that exhaust off. Right, get that turned off. I reckon this is full of bloody soot, you know. I run it for a couple of hours and I run it on low. It don't like it. On its own, before I put it in the barrel, it was fine. I can't see putting it in the barrel has made any difference at all. I think just running it on low, perhaps it gives it an opportunity to carbon up. But I'm going to take that off there and have a look down that pipe. break this exhaust paste now. Okay, let's try that one as well, just in case one goes and not the other. Well, at least that was on there. Give it a little... No. Right. Hit it too much because any problems we've got. Oh, here we go. Well, let me show you. I don't know if this is going to be blocked here or stuff in there. Right, there's a lot of soot there. A lot of soot in that. I wonder if that's restricting the pipe size. Maybe we need to go up a size in exhaust. I think the first thing I'm going to do is pull this out of the way. I might have to take the bricks out and then reconfigure that and just run it and see what happens. Because I did notice the combustion temperature was a little bit low when I last run it when I was running it on low, but I didn't think anything of it. I just, maybe it's cold out or whatever, but that would kind of explain it. So let me get this out of the way, get this put back. I'll have to take it off them wooden supports, lower it down, get that fitted out, used to be, and then we'll investigate this. If this runs all right, I'm going to run that, see if it comes up to temperature, because is it that this has caused a problem, or is there something wrong with that? So the quickest way is just to get this out of the way and put that back to standard. See all the carbon? Just flicking it out of exhaust, it's flung it all over there, and there's some of it in the hole. There's loads of soot in that pipe. I'm going to put an air blower down it, but I'm going to do that outside. But I'm going to get this heater back in there. And then the only other thing I've done is I've increased the length of that air intake, because obviously it wouldn't reach, because that's further away from the wall. But I haven't really run it for any length of time. So I don't think it's that. I think it's the bore of that, perhaps, over that length is just not enough. But let me get this situated. Right, that's back in. I've left the air intake the same length, just to hopefully rule that out. And what I'm hoping is this will burn clean now, and that combustion temperature will get back up to the 215, 220 mark. And more importantly, that it'll actually run. I suppose that's the good thing about not making too many serious changes to this design. It was easy to put back to standard. If this works, I'm gonna run it for an hour or two and try and burn it off. Run it quite high as well. Get rid of all this muck. You can see it's all soot coming out of it. And then we'll have a look at that barrel, see what's in there. I'll get you back when it starts clicking. It's just started clicking. It's not looking good. If this doesn't run, I'm going to have to strip this down and clean it out. That getting smoked out. I'm going to put a fan on, get rid of some of that. Oh, it's going well. Luckily, I've got a fan set up to dry this sand. Try and stop that from coming in. Right, well, I think what we've got here is a 100-pound smoke pump. That's not looking good at all. I have to crack that open and pull it apart. Right, let's turn that off. I think we're going to win with that one. What I might try, actually, I'll turn that off. What I might try is put some... What I might try is... I don't know what I did there, so I'm just clear a little bit. I'm going to take that air filter off and blow, use my handheld blower thing to see if I can't push some of that carbon out enough to get it to ignite. It's Heath Robinson, I know, bit of a bodge, but let's see what happens. I've done this once already, so... Try that again. It's towards the end there, it sounded like it was firing, but that might be wishful thinking on my part. Right. I bought this from Aldi. I don't even know why I bought it. I thought it was cheap. I thought, never know, it might come in handy. I use this thing all the time. Clean off bits of wood and that when you're doing a project. Right, let me press that button again. Let's see what happens now. Right, that's back on. That might be wishful thinking. The fan needs to up its game a bit as well. Stinks in here. If that works, it'll be the fastest decoke ever. Might have just made the whole thing worse. Combustion temperature went up to 24 degrees. There's no way it's 24 degrees in here. Or was that starting to clear? Just as I turned it off. I don't know, didn't look very promising, did it? Yeah, I might have to take it apart at some point anyway, just out of curiosity, even if this does work, just in case it's made a right mess in there. Right, I'll bring it back when it starts clicking, because this is like watching a pot boil, isn't it? All right, just started clicking. And that sounds much better. I think we had a blockage. Sounds better. Can you hear that sort of? Kind of whistling. I reckon there's still crap in there, you know. Right, I'm going to let this run. That's firing now, so that worked. Happy days. I'm going to let this run. Probably give it half an hour. Let's see what this combustion temperature does, because if we don't get over 200, we've still got a problem. Well, 52, and well, that's better. Right, while that's running, we'll see how much soot's in here. See if we can score a bullseye. Right, you ready? Hopefully this is running, because this is a one and done kind of situation. Yeah, I mean, it's not like it's a compressed airline, so I'm guessing we could probably get more out of that with compressed air. But, yeah, if you're looking at doing this 25mm stuff, 6 metres is too long. You don't like it. Because I was getting no soot before with just that little bit, so I think I've got to look at up in the size. I still want to try this, so maybe we'll go to inch and a half. People have commented about inch and a half. I think you were right. Let's try it. This is a lot cheaper. It's about 150 quid for inch and a half, for 6 metres. 205. Right, so we're getting there. I had this sneaky suspicion this wasn't going to work, you know, because when I did the flanges, I run it and it just didn't seem to get, that wasn't as hot. Normally this is, you can just about hold your hand in front of it. It didn't seem to get as hot, but I didn't run it for that long, and I thought, oh, it just hasn't run for as long. And the combustion temperature went up to, it peaked at 167, which I thought, again, well, it's not been on for that long, but I should have known. I think in the back of my mind, something was telling me it's not going well. The soot, I think the soot started the problem. I think that's what the problem is. It's caused a restriction. Well, it might be just the pipes caused the restriction, didn't like it. But it was running fine when I had it outside the barrel, but I don't think putting it in the barrel has caused it. But yeah, I think running it on low, but I don't want to not run it on low because that's on 5 and that clicking's annoying already. I like to have it down low and not have that rattling away so much. But yeah, the pump's another thing, isn't it? But however, I think we'll chalk this up as a fail in progress, because I don't want to draw a line through this yet. I think I'm going to try an inch and a half exhaust. Means adapting the flanges. I'll just probably cut these, split them, and then just cup it around the bottom, because the stuff that I've seen, Polylock, I think it's called, looks like it's thicker, so it might take a little bit more of a clamp on it, if you know what I mean. So I'll have to get some bigger clamps, but I'll still use them flanges. I'll just have to open the hole up and then split them. But yeah, I think I found someone that does them in continuous lengths as well. So if I can get 6 metres without having to worry about a join, it's just one less restriction to worry about. But then I've got to somehow step it down from inch and a half to 24 mil is the internal, or 25 external. Maybe I'll cut the existing exhaust and go over the concertina bits, load of exhaust paste, because as we see, that stuff's pretty much good at sticking these together. But anyway, hope you enjoyed my failure. Like it. If you didn't like it, give me a pity like, help me grow the channel, subscribe. I'll see you on the next one, which may be putting a bigger exhaust than that. But yeah, I'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.